I would like to play first. I don't think I mulligan this. I don't know, maybe I should because it doesn't have early drops, but Anawan's pretty good. Hedron Rover's not great. But I don't know. It seems like this is a borderline hand, but still probably better than an average six. I certainly would not keep this hand on the draw, and yeah, I mean, the fact that I don't have up to a four, actually, I probably should have just mulliganed this hand. If I draw any spell that costs three or less in the first couple turns, then the hand ends up, I think, being decent, but I guess I don't actually have that many that I could maybe afford to keep this. All right, let's see, though. My opponent's deck actually didn't seem that fast. Coombe Refuge, I would love to see that card. All right, another Hedron River. So now I have Swamp Swamp in case I draw Gatekeeper, and then next turn I can play Mountain for Burst Lightning if I need to. All right, Slaver Knolls. Ooh, that's gross. All right, well, I guess I'm going to be discarding here. Well, I only have to discard once, hopefully. Oh, wait, my opponent does not have a swamp. Haha. All right, that's good news. What are we seeing now? Surikar Marauder. Oh, thanks, Lacerator. That was right on time. All right. Playing a Hedron Rover, because even though I could play a Lacerator and it's actually a little worse, I don't really want to do that. All right, well, let's. 18. I'm just going to block the nulls here. I know I'm not discarding a card, and I know I'm hitting for 4, but given that my opponent's mana screwed, I really just don't want to take a bunch of damage. Zekhtar Shrine Expedition. Well, that's not a great card. All right, let's play Anawan the Ruined Sage. If my opponent can't kill it, then I'm getting a pretty solid amount of value. That's another reason to block, by the way, is that Hedron Rover is just going to die to Anawan anyway, so might as well take less damage. Trusty Machete. Well, that's a sick card. All right, could have just free roll attacked with the Surikar Marauder. No reason not to. Oop, let's not play that. Let's play Lacerator, hit my opponent down to 17. Now my opponent can only play vampires. I'm not playing lands here because of Solstice Expedition and these Hedron Rovers. And soon this Lacerator is going to stop dealing damage to me. Ooh, another vampire. All right, Anawan's a pretty nice one. I mean, now that I, you know, played it when I don't have to immediately block with it and I'm at zero life, it's doing a pretty good job of locking my opponent out. Granted, my opponent might not even be able to cast spells here, but there aren't that many spells that are relevant with Anawan in play. I guess my opponent could have like a Searing Blaze here, and that would be unfortunate. But any random non-vampire, like, alright. Stonework Puma resolves. And goes away. Alright, let's bash for 8. And I think I actually do just play a Hedron Rover here, since it's gonna die, but if it doesn't die, then. Or rather, if Anawan dies, then Hedron Rover's in play, and this way I can block a haste creature. Not that that was a big issue. All right. Relic Crush is kind of nice, but expensive, and I don't really want to play another color. Oh, Piranha Marsh. Should I have been playing Piranha Marsh? Look at my mana costs. Nah, I think I'm actually fine not playing Piranha Marsh here. All right. I think I'm ready to battle still. I mean, I just want to play a Shortcutter instead of a Rover because I'm on the draw. It's just, or actually, a Mindless Null is probably even better since it's a little more castable.